Igor and I study in class 11th commerce. So today I'm here with the topic Introduction to Economics, in which I'll be covering three points, that is, what is economics, three central problems and the classification of economics. So here I start with the definition of economics. Economics is a study of how people use scarce resources that is alternative uses to satisfy the unlimited wants. Now in this definition I have covered three points, that is, what are scarce resources. So scarce resources is when the demand is more than the supply. Now when is demand more than the supply? As we know that human wants are unlimited. If one want is fulfilled, we crave for another. Like if we have bike, we crave for I wish I could have car, and so on. Now but when we talk about alternative uses, so resources are limited and they have alternate use. Example, diesel and petrols are used to run cars and bikes, as well as they are used to run machineries. So here I guess I have completed my definition with all the three key points. Now coming further, we have the three central problems. Because the central problems include scarcity, limited resource and the alternative. So the first problem which we face in the economy is what to produce. What to produce means the choice between producing a good and in which quantity that we should produce that good. For example, we have wheat and rice. So if we choose to produce wheat, now we have to decide in which quantity we have to produce wheat, like in 5 quintal, 10 quintal and so on. Coming to how to produce gives us two choices, which is labor intensive or capital intensive. Labor intensive means to use more labor rather than capital, which is machineries and all. And capital intensive means using more capital like machineries and goods rather than using labors. And when we talk about the third problem, which is whom to produce deal with the problem that is distribution of goods and services among the individual in an economy. Now coming to the classification of economics, we have two types of economies, that is microeconomics and the macroeconomics. Microeconomics is the study of individual economic unit of an economy, whereas macroeconomics is the study of economics as a whole and its aggregates. Now coming to the tools, microeconomics is a demand and a supply of particular commodity or a factor, whereas macroeconomics aggregates the supply of economy as a whole. Now when I'll be giving the example states in microeconomics is the income of an individual and not as a group, whereas macroeconomics is a national income which is in a group and not in an individual person. So now I guess I have completed all my three points which I included. First was the definition of economics, second was the classification of economics, and the third was the three central problems and the keywords like scarce resources, alternative and the unlimited wants. So here I end. I would like to conclude. Thank you, like Shilpi ma'am, thank you for just making me understand that all these topics so easily, and I hope you like my video.